Good morning, everyone. Today I'm here with the topic food and its sources. As you all know, all the living organisms eat something or the other for their survival. That is the food. Let us take into consideration what is food, and then further on we will proceed towards its sources. Firstly, what is food? All the substances which we eat or drink is termed as the food. Let us take into consideration an example. Have you ever thought of a car when there is no fuel in it? What will happen? It stops running. So food is like a fuel. It helps us to do all our daily activities and keeps us healthy. Let us take into consideration our next topic, that is the uses of the food. Now the question arises is, why do we need food? We need food as it acts as a fuel for our body. It keeps us healthy and help us in doing all our day-to-day activities. It protects our body from various diseases and it helps in the growth and repair of the worn-out cells and tissues from the body. You might have seen children, some are very much fat and some are very much lean in nature. Have you all ever thought why this is so? Just because they don't take food in a proper manner. Now, let us consider the next one, that is the varieties of food. You all take food in a number of forms. It's not like you take only one thing in a particular day. No, you take the breakfast in a different way, lunch in a different manner, and for the dinner, you take different food items. So there are different varieties of the food which we take. As we consider the northern parts of the India, we will see the famous food items are in the northern parts, the famous food items are rajma and rice, whereas in the southern parts, the famous food items are idli, curry and dosa. As you can see, there are different varieties of food items all over India, and we take different food items for our all the daily activities. Now, for the preparation of food, we require certain ingredients. Now, the question arises is, what are ingredients? Ingredients are the raw materials which are needed to prepare any food item. For example, if we are cooking a boiled rice, we only require two ingredients, that is the rice and the water. For example, let us take into consideration another example. If we have to prepare any sort of pulse, we require more than enough ingredients. That is, some of the food items require only two ingredients, while other requires more than two ingredients for the preparation. We eat food items in a raw form also, as well as in a cooked form also. In a raw food items, we include salad, nuts, etc. We eat salad and nuts in a raw form, whereas the other food items such as rice, vegetables, pulses, we eat all such in a cooked form. Some of the food items can be eaten in a raw form, whereas some of the food items can be eaten while proper cooking. Now, the next topic is the sources of food. Now, the main sources of food are the plants and the animals. And plants are considered as the main source of the food. Now, let us see how. We all eat lots of food items every day. Now, where does these food items come from? These food items basically come from the plants. Plants provide us with vegetables, cereals, pulses, fruits and many other items. Now we eat lots of food items every day, and these all comes from the plants. We eat the plant parts also which are edible in nature, and those parts which can be eaten by all the living organisms, they are termed as the edible parts of the plants. Now let us take into consideration some of the examples which we take every day. We eat roots of the plants as potatoes, carrots, radish. All these food items are the roots of the plants which we eat every day. We eat leaves of the plants as the lettuce leaves and the spinach. Now examples for the fruits are pumpkin, tomatoes. Now inflorescence vegetables, these include broccoli as well as the cauliflower, and we eat stem of the plants as bamboo shoots and asparagus. These are few examples which we eat every day from the plant parts. Next is the animals as a source of food. The main source of the food is the plant, but animals are also considered as a source of food, as we eat lots of items which are being produced by the animals. Let us see how. Firstly, milk. Milk is itself considered as a wholesome food. Wholesome means proper food in itself. Milk is being obtained from the milk yielding animals such as cows, goats, camels, etc. And some of the food items are also prepared from the milk, such as cheese, curd and butter. Next food item which we get from the animals is egg. Egg is considered as a super food, and it is obtained from the poultry birds such as hen, duck and turkeys. Meat is the animal flesh which is being eaten by the living organisms. Those who eat meat, they are considered as the non-vegetarians. These are obtained from the meat yielding animals such as hen, goat, etc. Honey. Honey is a sweet, thick, liquid substance which is a complete food in itself. It is being prepared by the honey bees. It nourishes the body. Now, how does it get prepared? Honey bees collect the nectar. What is a nectar now? Nectar is a sweet juice which is being collected from the flowers. Honeybees collect the nectar from the flowers and convert it into honey in their hive. It is the only food which includes all the substances necessary to sustain life. And rearing of honeybees are called as the apiculture. Food habits, that what all the living organisms eat. All the living organisms have been categorized into herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. Now let us discuss one by one in detail. First of all comes the herbivores. Herbivores contain the word herbs, which means plants. So these are the organisms which are only plant eating. For example, cow, goat and elephant. These organisms have flat molar teeth for the chewing of the plants. Next category is of the carnivores. Carnivores are the flesh-eating animals. They have long pointed canine teeth for the tearing of the meat. The examples which are included in the carnivores are lion, tiger, etc. Next one is the omnivores. Omnivores are those living organisms which eat both plant as well as the animals. These types of organisms can easily get their food because they eat both the types of plants as well as the animals. The examples which have been included in the category of omnivores are human beings, chimpanzees, monkeys, bear, etc. Now, there are more categories of animals which are also included in their food habits. These are, firstly, are the scavengers. These are those animals which feed on the dead bodies of the other organisms. For example, vultures, eagles, hyenas, etc. Now, next one is the decomposers. Decomposers are those organisms which break down the dead bodies of the decaying animals into the simpler substances. They help in clearing the atmosphere. The examples which have been included under the category of decomposers are worms, mushrooms, insects, and bacteria. Parasites. Parasites are the organisms which live either on or inside the bodies of other organisms. They feed on the bodies of the organisms which we call as the host. These are either microscopic in nature, that is, which cannot be seen with our naked eyes, while others can be seen with our naked eyes. Some of the parasites are microscopic in nature, that is, which cannot be seen with our naked eyes, whereas some of the parasites can be seen with our naked eyes. The examples which have been included under this category are leech, lice, mites, etc. Okay, let us conclude now. Today we have read about the food and its sources. Food are the substances which we eat or drink. Next, we study about why do we need food? It helps our body to do all the day-to-day life activities. It keeps us healthy and it helps in the growth and repair of the worn-out cells and tissues. Then we read about the varieties of food, as I have given you the examples. In the northern parts of India, rice and rajma are famous, whereas in the southern parts of the India, idli, dosa, curry are famous. Next, we read about the ingredients of food. For preparing any food item, we require certain ingredients. That is, the raw materials which we need to prepare any food item are termed as its ingredients. Next, we studied about the sources of the food. The main sources of food are the plants and the animals. Then, we study about what all things we get from the plants, that is, vegetables, cereals, pulses, and fruits. Then, we studied regarding the various examples, that what are the edible parts of the plants and what do we get from the edible parts of the plants and what are the things we eat from the different parts of the plants. Then we studied about the animals as a source of food, what all things we get from the animals, that is the milk, which is itself considered as a wholesome food, the egg, which is being considered as a superfood, the meat, which is the animal flesh, which is being eaten by the organisms, and those who eat the animal flesh, they are considered as the non-vegetarians. Honey, it is a sweet, thick liquid substance which is being prepared by the honeybees. It nourishes the body and is considered as a complete food in itself. Next, we studied about the different food habits. That is, the herbivores, these are the plant-eating animals. Then the carnivores, these are the flesh-eating animals. Then we studied about the omnivores, these are the animals which eat both plants as well as the animals, and they can easily get their food as they depend upon both plants and the animals. Then we studied about the more types of the food habits, that is the scavengers. These are those organisms which feed on the dead bodies of other organisms. Decomposers, these are the organisms which break down the dead bodies or decaying organisms into the simpler substances. Parasites, these are those organisms which either live on or inside the bodies of other organisms. They can be microscopic or can be seen with our naked eyes.